Another one that shows up all the very frequently is missing values. So sometimes missing values are because information is not collected. So when you're looking at census information or survey information in particular, people will often decline to give their age and weight, or will decline to give their annual income. So you just have missing values. Other times, the attributes that you're collecting may not be applicable to all cases, right? If you're asking people about the annual income of each member of their household on a survey, well, the children in the household don't have an annual income, right? It doesn't make sense. So you just code that as a missing value. And we'll talk a lot more about handling missing values when we talk when we get to data pre-processing. But the fundamental ways we kind of the fundamental ways we can handle it are it throw out all the data objects that throw out all the data objects that have any missing values. We can estimate our missing values using means or medians or something else. We can, with some algorithms but not all, ignore the missing values on a row-by-row basis, or we can just throw the attribute out entirely, which is something we might want to do if, you know, if we have an attribute that is 80% missing, we probably just want to throw that column out. And one of the ways, one of the other things you can do sometimes in some algorithms is you replace missing values adaptively with, this happens a lot in categorical, where you'll count the probabilities of an attribute appearing, an attribute value appearing over your whole data set, and then replace all the missing values with such that those probabilities don't change. And we'll talk a little bit more about that when we get to pre-processing. I just wanted to sort of get the basic sort of this is how you handle missing values in a very basic sense out there. And along the third category then, alongside missing values, noise, and outliers, is duplicate data. So this is particularly a problem when data objects are, when we're merging data from heterogeneous sources. So if we have some data from Google Analytics coming from our website, and then we have some other data from you know, actual uses, you know, click counts and sort of dwelling time and things like that, that's from another system, or maybe we have a Java applet that, you know, as much as those things still exist on the internet, that collects some data inside of it. If we want to merge that data, we will sometimes have duplicate data objects. We'll have the same person with multiple email addresses. We'll have the same person represented with two different IDs because they're coming from two different systems. So generally speaking, duplicate data, though, is pretty easy to handle, assuming that you can detect it properly, which is get rid of the duplicates, merge it together. But if you've got data that's heterogeneous, that's from multiple sources, then you do have to be really careful about filtering out your duplicates.